Hi, I'm Paul Grisco.
Sam Huddle here.
I'm Sean the Nerdish.
My name is Jerome Polstra.
And this is our Mangrove Research Initiative. Florida mangroves.
There are three main species of mangroves in Florida. Here's to now.
They grow in layers from coastal to inland in the order of red, black, white, and buttonwood. They each have unique characteristics when it comes to reproduction, which are evident in their seeds.
All mangrove species reproduce by forming seeds called propagules. Similar to budding, they all start growing before leaving the tree. After leaving their respective trees, these seeds drift to find a new home. Red mangrove seeds can be identified with their long, tube-like shapes. They can survive for more than a year before taking root. Black mangroves have elliptical seeds that look similar to a lima bean. They last for 110 days. White mangroves have fleshy seeds that resemble fruit. These seeds only last for 40 days. Over time, they begin to grow,
creating huge coastal forests that cover most of Southwest Florida. South Florida alone is estimated to contain over 430,000 acres of mangrove forests. They provide protection to all sorts of life, especially on places such as Marco Island, where hurricanes are a constant threat. They make it possible for countless species to live, such as this angel wing, by filtering pollutants and heavy metals out of the water and trapping them beneath the detritus under the root, as well as providing a nursery for young fish to live and grow. Calusa Indians use the rich biodiversity of mangrove estuaries to survive. However, mangroves face many challenges. Freshwater runoff and pollution from land are two threats to mangroves. Beach erosion makes it difficult for mangrove forests to expand. The carbon dioxide released by recreational and commercial boaters seeps into mangrove habitats. Commercial and residential building has drastically reduced mangrove territory. Marco Island has problems with mangrove sustainability. This area is known as Fruit Farm Creek. The construction of State Road 92 blocked the historic water flow into the creek, which has been quite a legislative headache for City Council. Despite the difficult situation with jurisdiction over who owns the road, progress is being made. This is due to the efforts of Rookery Bay National Estuarine Research Reserve and a private organization known as the Coastal Resource Group, Incorporated.
One, an issue of funding. More often than not, funding for environmental restoration tends to be of secondary or tertiary concern. A large obstacle that I've experienced is that oftentimes there are competing interests from different stakeholders. And by that I mean that there are different people who have different concerns about the natural resources that they live either within or adjacent to. And so sometimes they have different things that they want to have done or different ways they want to see their money spent. And, you know, when you have more people with a voice, that's always a great thing.
Mangroves are essential for three major reasons in Southwest Florida: by providing a safe habitat for both land and sea animals to grow, also boosting our local economy with tourist attraction, fishing charters, and 10,000 island tours,
and lastly, helping fight our main natural disaster threat, hurricanes, by combating their rising sea levels.
In order to sustain future mangrove life, we must all work together to preserve Southwest Florida's most essential natural resource.